Welcome to Interesting Logs. Today we are going to discuss about Aurora, which is a natural electrical phenomena. So auroras can be of two different types, aurora borealis or northern lights, which can be seen in the northern hemisphere. The second one is aurora australis, southern lights, which can be seen in the southern hemisphere. Now you may be wondering that how are they formed? So when charged protons and electrons emitted from the sun penetrate Earth's magnetic shield and collide with atoms and molecules in our atmosphere, auroras are formed. Photons which result from the collisions are little bursts of light which make up the aurora. Red and green auroras are produced with oxygen collisions. Pink and purple colors are emitted through nitrogen collisions. Auroras encircle the polar regions of Earth 40 to 400 miles in altitude. These zones are called the aurora ovals. Now most of you will have many questions and queries about the auroras. Where can you see an aurora? Aurora borealis can be seen in the northern countries like central Alaska and Canada, Greenland and northern Scandinavia and Russia. Aurora australis can be seen from the ocean circling Antarctica, but it can occasionally reach the far edges of New Zealand, Chile and Australia. Do other planets have auroras? Auroras have been observed on Jupiter, Saturn and Uranus, but not on Mars, Venus and Mercury. Any planet with a magnetic field and an atmosphere should likely have auroras. Mars and Venus have no global magnetosphere. Mercury has almost no atmosphere. Do the auroras make sound? Observers have speculated about this for hundreds of years, noting that they have heard crackling, swishing, and hissing sounds while they watch aurora dance in the sky. But scientific experiments have been unable to detect any audible sound from the northern lights, and most scientists cannot find a reason why the lights should make a sound. The air in the upper part of atmosphere where the auroras are formed is too thin to conduct audible sound any distance. So, if sounds are heard, they must come from some other phenomena occurring at the same time. Etymology. The word aurora is derived from the name of the Roman goddess of dawn. Aurora, who traveled from east to west announcing the coming of the sun. Ancient Greek poets used the name metaphorically to refer to dawn, often mentioning its play of colors across the otherwise dark sky. So friends, that's all for today. Hope you liked the video. Please subscribe the channel, like and share our videos. Jai Hind friends.